Aki Kareem for British Boxers. So we are here at the press conference for George Groves versus Chris Eubank Jr. But we have one of the undercard fighters with us. We have Sebastian Eubank with us, who I believe makes your pro debut on Saturday.
My pro debut.
Tell me a little bit about your background in boxing then. I mean, you obviously grew up in a boxing family, but tell me a little bit about your own legacy.
Well, I went through the amateur ranks. You know, there's a lot of politics involved in that. I won some titles. I got to the quarterfinals of the ABAs. I got robbed very badly in that. That would have put me in the finals with Buatsi to eventually go on to the Olympics. But everything for a reason. I think I've had around 36 amateur fights. Won the majority of them, so I've been through the amateur experience, got what I needed from that, and I took a step out after I realised that, you know, sometimes you just can't beat the judges sometimes, you know. And then since then I've just been on my own journey, doing lots of different things, travelling the world, training, you know, a spiritual journey, so to speak. Which I didn't really want to, I didn't want the invasion of privacy that comes with boxing, you know, that I know all too well from, you know, having grown up with my father. I didn't want that to hinder anything. So, you know, I took a little step away from the boxing, still training. But as far as the amateur ranks goes and turning pro, I just held back a little bit. I'm 26 years old now, you know, nothing before its time, and the time is now.
Time is now. And what weight? I mean, you look quite thick set and you're a muscular one. What weight would you be turning over at?
Light heavy.
That's light heavy, right? Yeah. Okay, great.
I mean, I can get down to super middle. I could probably go up to cruiser, but I think light heavy suits me the best. Yeah. I don't have to kill myself to make weight. I don't have to overeat. Light heavy is the one I'm going to go.
And I believe you're training in Manchester now, over at the Fight Factory. And Sean Cruise, you know, is a good nutritionist as well, isn't he?
That's why me and Sean get along. You know, we've got the same views on nutrition. As a plant-based whole food diet, and with that, you know, we just started gelling very well, and as a coach he's great as well. I'm not always up here because I'm based in Brighton and I move around a lot. I train over in Dubai, I train in London, but when I am in Manchester or when I have the time, I come up and I train with Sean.
Yeah. Now, I've also seen some footage of you you know, training with Chris, your brother, in the lead up to this fight.
Yeah.
Now obviously, in terms of quality sparring, I mean, you've got an advantage, haven't you, really? And you know, he wasn't taking ease on you either in that spar. He was really letting them shots fly.
There's no mercy from Chris.
I can't believe it.
No mercy from Chris.
But that's a great learning curve for you, isn't it?
Oh yeah, definitely. It's a massive confidence booster when you can last rounds with somebody like Junior. You know, there's not really anything that can scare you or make you doubt yourself, you know. So I've got the rounds in with Junior, as you said, as you saw, like, he doesn't go easy, so I know I can last with Chris. I know I can actually give some back as well. So confident for Saturday, and I'll continue to spar with Chris and continue to keep growing as a fighter.
And interestingly as well, you're a southpaw, a light heavyweight southpaw who's very mobile. I've seen you're very mobile. You've got quite a low swung guard as well. You switch it, you pick your shots.
Yeah.
So it could be a really entertaining style as well for the fans.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't want to. Once I mastered my original style, after that I thought, you know, why not add to your arsenal? You know, just pick as many different styles as I like that I thought I could imitate and just practice them. I had an injury on my right shoulder, and that made me actually switch my stance, and for about a year I just trained as an orthodox fighter. So now I have that in my arsenal as well. I'm a switch hitter. I know how to fight like Chris, you know, speed, and just use a combination of punches to beat my opponent, or I can pick my shots and just go for the one punch knockout, which I also have in my arsenal. So,
well, really looking forward to this debut on Saturday.
Thanks, man.
You know what the final question I'm going to ask you is a bit of a cliche question. How do you see the fight going on Saturday between your brother and George Groves?
I see it going to maybe around round 8, round 9, and I think after that once Groves can't, you know, he doesn't have it in his tank to be running any longer, I think Chris will catch up to him and overwhelm him. But also having sparred Chris, his power's increased significantly in the last couple of months, or maybe over the last year. So I think if Groves slips up early in the fight and Chris catches him, Chris will knock him out. You know, he's definitely punching harder than Froch, for sure. So if Froch can knock Groves out, then yeah.
That's a big call, that one.
When you know.
So, okay.
So yeah.
Well, I'll take your word on it because you felt the punches, and I haven't.
Yeah. Eubank's got this for sure. It's in the bag. Groves, you know, he's slippery. He's a little bit awkward. People say he's got a strong right hand. I don't believe Groves punches harder than me, and I've caught Chris with some flush shots, and he eats them up and then pays you back. So.
Right, okay, brilliant. Well, listen, I really appreciate your time. Looking forward to your debut.
Thank you, man.
On Saturday, and to watching you carve your own legacy out.
Yes, thank you very much.
See you fight night. Take care. Appreciate it.